introduction, unit number 1, partial differential equation. Okay, so unit 1, partial differential equations, PDEs. Okay, this is the first unit. After this, the first one is the formation of PDEs. Formation of PDEs, how to frame the or find or construct the partial differential equations. And there are two techniques to frame the PDEs. The first one is eliminating the arbitrary constants. Eliminating the arbitrary constants. If it is some arbitrary constants involves in the given relationship, then we eliminate those constants. Other hand, if there are some arbitrary functions, then we try to eliminate that too. So in these two techniques we are going to get, while eliminating the arbitrary constants or the functions, then we will get the partial differential equations. And once we frame the partial differential equation, we can go for the reverse. What's the reverse? What is the solution? What is the solution of PDEs? So the second topic is solutions of partial differential equations, PDEs. And there are four types of solutions. One is complete, second one is particular, third one is general, third one is singular, and the fourth one is general. So these are the four different types of solutions. It's often called as integrals. Complete integral, particular integral, general singular integral, and fourth one is general integral. So these are four different types of integrals. And the solutions of PDEs can be divided according to their order. What is my order? Order is nothing but how many times we differentiate the variable. The maximum, the highest number is called the order. So this can be divided based on its order. It is a first order differential equations, partial differential equation, and second or higher order differential equations. Second or higher order PDEs. So these are the two different types of topics in solutions of PDEs. In the first order partial differential equations, we have some standard types only. Some standard types. What are the types? Type number 1. It's a function of P, comma Q is equal to 0. I can tell you what is P, what is Q later. Number 2 is called Z is equal to Px plus Qy plus the function of P, comma Q. This is known as a Clairaut's equation. C-L-A-U-I. Clairaut's equation. C-L-A-I-R-A-U-T-S. Clairaut's equation. Third one is the function of Z, comma P is equal to 0. And fourth one is called separable type equation. It's a function of X, comma P is equal to a function of Y, comma Q. This is called separable type equation. And the fifth one is called the PP plus QQ is equal to R. Is often called as Lagrange's linear equation. Lagrange's linear equation. So these are the five standard types in the first order partial differential equations. Right? The second or higher order PDE is the complete solution consisting of two parts. One is called the complementary function CF, and the second one is particular integral. You see, the complementary function depends upon the given left hand side relation, and the particular integral depends upon the right hand side one, because it will generate from the right hand side. When we give the particular values to the right hand side function, we will get the particular integral. So this is the required complete solution of the second or higher order PDEs. This already we did in the lower classes. It looks like the ordinary differential equation only. We can extend here one more operator for the partial derivatives. So let's see detail when you go for this topic. And the particular derivatives depends upon the right hand side function. So there are some standard functions in the case of the right hand side PI. One is exponential, e to the power ax plus by. Second one is trigonometric, sin or cos mx plus ny. Third one is the polynomial, the x to the power m into y to the power n. And these are three standard forms or types of function. And the fourth one is product of the exponential and the other two functions. So these are the topics what we have in the second or higher order partial differential equations. As exam point of view, we expect one part B and 4 mark question and one part B 12 mark question or maybe a 6 mark question from this formation of PDEs. In the first order PDEs, you may expect the first type, fourth type is part B 4 mark questions. Part B 4 mark questions. And the second, third and fifth one, it is the fifth one is very very important, Lagrange's linear equations. It's a part C question, minimum it is 4 marks, maximum it comes 12 mark question. And the third one, it is compulsory here, part C question. The second one is Clairaut's equations, also your part C question. So you may see some different skeleton of this unit number 1 with the first order PDE. And from the second or higher PDEs, minimum one part B 4 mark question and maximum one 12 mark question. So this is the exact blueprint of this unit number 1. Right?